Hello guys, this is Anprashanti from Yacht Medical Academy. I just want to share my ideas for you to remember easily on the topic of skeletal system. Skeletal system consists of framework of bones and few cartilages. Bones and cartilages are specialized as a connective tissue. In our body, human skeleton is made up of 206 bones. And here the skeletal system is divided into two divisions, axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Axial skeleton consists of 80 bones, appendicular skeleton consists of 126 bones. Let us move on to the axial skeleton. Axial skeleton is again divided into four subdivisions. They are skull, vertebral column, ribs and sternum. Let's move on to the skull. Skull is divided into two types, cranial bones and facial bones. Cranial bones are divided into two types, paired bones and unpaired bones. The paired bones are parietal bone and temporal bone. Unpaired bones are frontal bone, sphenoid bone, occipital bones and ethmoid bone. Let us see, cranium bones are 18 number and it forms a and it is also called as cranium box. Let us see, next one is facial bones. Facial bones are 14 in number and it is also called as skeletal elements. Let us see the skeletal elements. Skeletal elements are nasal bones, maxillae, zygomatic, lacrimal, mandibles, palatine bones, and nasal cochlea and vomer. Lacrimal is nothing but our eye orbit, which is the smallest bone in our facial region. Zygomatic bone is nothing but our cheek bones, and the mandibles is the largest bone and it is longest bone. And the next, ear ossicles. Each middle ear consists of three tiny bones. They are stapes, incus and malleus. Friends, we can remember in the shortcut form of SIM. I repeat again, stapes, incus and malleus. And the second one is vertebral column. And a single U-shaped bone called hyoid bone, which is present in our base of the buccal cavity. Friends, can you guess it? Why we call our skull is diconic skull? Two occipital condyles are present, one each side of the foramen magnum. Our vertebral column is formed 26 serially arranged units called vertebra and it is dorsally placed. First vertebra called atlas. And they are differentiated into cervical 7 bones, which is followed by thoracic bones. Thoracic bones are 12 and lumbar bones 5 in number. It is a free vertebra. And next one is sacrum and cochigeal. Cochigeal is a non-functional bone. Friends, we already discussed in the beginning that the appendicular skeleton consists of 126 bones. It includes four limbs and two griddles. They are human consists a pair of legs and hands. Let us see the composition of bones in our hands. First humerus. Humerus is attached to the radius and ulna, which is jointed to the carpals. Carpals are 7 in number and metatarsals are 5 in number. And the phalanges are digits, nothing but digits. Digits, only thumb contains two bones, but the four digit contains three bones. And friends, composition of bones in our legs. First is femur. Femur is the longest bone and is also called as thigh bone, and which is attached to the tibia and fibula, and it is jointed to the tarsals. Tarsals are 7 in number and metatarsals are 5 in number. Phalanges is 7 in number. And friends, here only we covered 120 bones, remaining 6 bones forming the griddles, pectoral griddle and pelvic griddles. Pectoral griddle is nothing but our shoulder bones and pelvic griddle is nothing but our hip griddles. Let us see about a brief information about pectoral griddle. Pectoral griddle consists of two bones, clavicle and scapula. Scapula is a large triangular bone and clavicle is a long slender bone which is also called as collar bones. And let us see pelvic griddle. Pelvic griddle consists of two coxal bones. Each coxal bone is fused to form ilium, ischium and pubis. Friends, the next topic is joints. Joints are essential for all types of movements and many other movements. Joints is point contact between cartilages and bones. Joints are consist of fibrous joint, cartilaginous joint and synovial joint. Fibrous joint is nothing but it does not allow the any movement. For example, flat skull bones to form the cranium. A and the cartilage nerves where the bones are involved, which involve with the help of the joints, and it is also cartilage nerve. For example, adjacent vertebra in our vertebral column. The last one is synovial joint. Synovial joint is helps in locomotion and many other movements. For example, hinge joint, which is present in our knee joint. And then the next one is present between saddle joint is nothing but our thumb, which is present between carpals and metacarpals of thumb. And the last topic in my subtopic is disorders. Arthritis, inflammation of joints. Inflammation is nothing but swallowing of our joints. And osteoporosis, it reduces the calcium ions in our bones. And the last one is arthritis. Arthritis means inflammation of joints due to accumulation of uric acid crystals. Thank you friends, I think hope you like the video. You can subscribe at YouTube and Facebook, and Mia's Medical Academy giving the best wishes in NEET examination.